Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times. We're here today with Jaclyn Sivers, who is running for re-election to the Clarkston School Board. How are you today?
I'm good, thanks. How are you doing?
Great. Thank you so much for
Good.
being here. Can you
Yeah.
just tell us how long have you been on the school board for?
I was appointed to the school board in August of 2023.
And in that time, what are some of the things that you're most proud of?
Oh my gosh, there's so much to be proud of when it comes to Clarkston Community School. I actually made a points of pride page on my website to highlight our successes because our school district is just so phenomenal. Before I was appointed, I was involved with the Board of Education, and I said that we needed, or I'd like to see an elementary school resource officer. I wanted to see a school safety director. I wanted to see us, partner with the Oakland County Sheriff's Office with the Handle with Care initiative, and I wanted an independent follow-up of our security audit. When I was appointed, I was immediately assigned to the school safety committee, and I'm really proud to say that we actually have all of those things in place now, alongside all of the additional target hardening measures that we approved as a board. I'm really proud that I can tell every parent in our district that we have a security expert on staff whose sole job is to keep our school safe. I really hope that gives families some sort of peace of mind. We also opened this summer, we opened our employment contracts early and our staff received raises. So I'm really proud to say that we're paying our teachers and staff as much as the district can afford, and that will remain the goal of the board.
Can you tell us a little bit about your professional experience, some of the skills you bring to the table?
Sure. So I've been a licensed attorney since 2011. I was a public defender for 6 years in Ohio. I'm going on 6 years now as a prosecutor, the last four of which I've been an assistant prosecuting attorney at the Oakland County Prosecutor's Office in the Juvenile Justice Division. I was the dedicated prosecutor for our juvenile drug court. I'm currently the dedicated prosecutor for our juvenile mental health court. I was a part of the Restorative Justice Initiative at the prosecutor's office, as well as project lead. So, in the role, I mean, obviously, in addition to prosecuting juvenile delinquency cases, we represent the Department of Health and Human Services and abuse and neglect cases, protecting the children that come out of homes with abuse and neglect. I do trainings for police, Air Force cadets, our schools, on juvenile law, school threats, struggles that juveniles have, our Oakland County resources for juveniles and families, as well as the schools. Really, every day I collaborate with community organizations. I battle in the courtroom. I sit down with families and schools, superintendents, law enforcement. And it's really all on behalf of our kids. Like every day at work is all about the kids, the challenges they face, the supports that families and schools need. Back in law school, I received the Public Interest Service Award because honestly, like public service is at my heart. When I applied for the appointment for the board, it just really felt like a natural extension of my job in terms of knowledge regarding juvenile law, the juvenile justice system, resources in the community for kids and families, research and training on threat assessments, best practices in schools. I'm just like excited to continue the work in all of my roles.
What are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
In the community, so my family and I are really big supporters of Kaya and SCAMP in Clarkston. We're members of Christ the Redeemer Church. My daughter and I love volunteering at Micah 6 in their community garden. I'm a Moms Demand Action volunteer. In terms of the school community involvement, I'm on the PTA. I'm a classroom volunteer for Reading Milestones. I do that as much as possible or as much as my job allows. I'm on the garden committee for the elementary school. I'm a room parent for holiday classroom parties. I'm a career day volunteer for CCS. My friend and I, or my colleague and I, are starting the Clarkston mock trial program this year. So I'm really excited to see that go into effect for our fourth graders. Earlier this year, I actually received the Oakland County 40 Under 40 Award by our county commissioner, our county executive. And earlier this year, I actually received the Clarkston Citizen of the Year Award for 2024, which was a huge honor.
So what are some of the things that you'd like to work on if the voters keep you in this spot?
Well, like I said before, we have a lot to be proud of at Clarkston Community Schools, and I want to work on marketing those successes to our community who may have either an inaccurate or outdated perception of just how great our schools are. Just like a quick side story, my husband and I moved from Ohio back home to Michigan, and before we moved, we were looking to move to the area that we currently live in Clarkston. And the realtor that we were working with actually talked us out of moving to Clarkston because the schools weren't great. And as a mom, that was my top priority. So we went somewhere else for maybe a year, year and a half, you know, fast forward 18 months, and we're actually living in the subdivision that we originally wanted to live in because I did my research and figured out that our schools were awesome. Our district was phenomenal, and Clarkston schools are something to be proud of. So that's just how my own life was affected by a misperception or inaccurate data. So I want to figure out how to really market our successes of the school district to our community at large. I know our time's limited, so I'll probably just highlight a few of my goals. I do have a page on my website that lists a lot of my goals and issues if anybody wants more details. But I know I said before that we've done a lot of work and we've made really big improvements in terms of school security. That's obviously my number one priority. I've always said that there's no end goal when it comes to safety. Our kids can't reach their full academic and extracurricular potential unless they feel safe first. Parents deserve the peace of mind that sending their kids to school is a safe decision. Staff deserve to feel safe when they go to work every day. So I would love to see like a schedule of audits and updates by our security director. I want to better educate our student population as well as our families on the laws surrounding juveniles. I want us to engage in and report on like advanced research and trainings and preventing threats and addressing those core issues. We have a full-time security director now. That is a brand new position that I'm really proud of. And I think it has a lot of potential to grow in our school district. And I'm just really committed to seeing that through. On the academic side, our administration has been researching and presenting on a new like ELA curriculum that I'm really excited to see through. That decision is going to require a lot of ground research that has already started, a lot of studies to just ensure that it's the right long-term investment for our district. I'm really excited to see our multi-tiered systems of supports progress into our secondary schools and finalizing the MTSS handbook for consistency. One of our board goals that we talked about earlier this year is to develop and expand curricular programs for our advanced learners in the younger grades, which I think is a really good goal to have. I'm excited to see how that progresses. Our 2022 bond implementation is underway. So we broke ground at the new junior high in May, and I was there with a shovel and a hard hat. We got the tour of the phase one part. It's not completed yet, but it's really close. And, that was really exciting to see kind of like the foundation of the new gym go up and plans being put in place. It's wonderful to see how families have adapted to that construction zone and our teachers that work there. So this is going to be a really big project, like several years project that's going to require the board to ensure that that money and those funds are appropriated responsibly. And as always, like with safety and long-term use in mind.
So in this race, there are a few people running for just a couple of positions. Why should the voters pick you?
Yeah, that's a good question. I mean, I think first and foremost, I have a unique set of knowledge and skill set when it comes to my profession that I bring to the school board. I think that's really unique to a school to have somebody that works in juvenile justice system. It's not just about the laws, but also about the resources that Oakland County can provide. I have really strong relationships with our law enforcement, which I think is really important, especially in this day and age. I just live and breathe juveniles. I live and breathe the best interests of kids every day. And truly, the board feels like a very natural extension of that. But, you know, I think the most important thing that I bring is that I'm a mom. I'm a mom of two young kids in the district. I have a kindergartner and a second grader. I have a really long-term investment in how the district's doing. And I can promise that every decision that I make on the board is going to be with my mom hat on, because not only are the voters' kids going to be affected, but my kids are going to be affected. And obviously my kids are the most important thing to me. So that's what I'll always have in front of me when making decisions and policies on the board.
So if voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
I think the website is going to be the most comprehensive place to go. So that's www.sivers, so S-I-V-E-R-S, for the word, so F-O-R, schools.com. So sivers4schools.com. Social media posts, I have a handle, Sivers for Schools, on Facebook. My email address is at the bottom of my website. I'm always available to talk, or you can submit forms through my website that go directly to me.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us today.
No, thank you for having me. I appreciate it.